Hello, my name is David Faure and I work for KDAB. In this third video of the series on debugging and profiling, I would like to talk to you specifically about profiling C and C++ applications. The first thing I would like to discuss is how to approach profiling before we talk about the actual tools. Because it's quite important to have a technique for doing this properly to avoid the trap of changing something, hoping it's better. I commit it, I go home. Well, sometimes we need to make sure that we actually improve things. So the way we are going to do that is first by assessing what is important in terms of performance in my project. Is it the CPU usage? Is it the off CPU time when my application is sleeping or waiting for something to happen? Is it memory allocations? Is it the battery usage that is a problem? Do I want to improve the frame rate? So it can be many, many different things. It's not just one measure. It's a whole set of measures. So first we assess what is important for my project. What do I want to measure? Then what we are going to do is to decide which tools we can use to do these measurements. So there are many different tools and they all cover a number of possible things to measure. And we are going to talk about those. Right, so I have selected my tools. Now, what I should do is write a benchmark. That means a reliable way of measuring something in my application. If I have to start the application, click here, click there, load a file, wait for something to be downloaded and so on and so on, I won't be able to do this three times in a row and get the same measurements. It's much better if I write some sort of automated test, like a unit test, but the purpose is not correctness, it's benchmarking, which means measuring performance of a specific task. Right, so I have decided what to measure, how to measure, and I write a benchmark to actually be able to measure that reliably. Now, I will finally use one of the tools to run the benchmark and establish a baseline, which is the numbers that apply to my benchmark initially before I made any changes to the code. And finally, I'm at step 5. It's only at that step that I will change the code and then measure the result compared to the baseline and decide if the change is an improvement or not. And that can be a bit tricky if possibly it's better on one measure and worse on another one, and I need to decide if that's good enough or if I should refine the solution. So what you would do then is measure again with the changes and then repeat up to step 4, profiling again, and then step 5, make the changes again, and so on and so on. Possibly at some point choosing different measures. Those steps 2 to 5 actually require tools. So now we are going to talk about which tools to use for which kind of measurement. Let's talk first about measurements of performance, specifically CPU and off CPU performance. To do that, I can use VTune, which is made by Intel. It's a very powerful tool to do these things. It has a very nice user interface. It exists for Linux and Windows. And we discovered that it's free if you download it as part of Intel System Studio. Don't look for it separately as VTune, but as part of the System Studio suite of tools, then it's actually free for use, even for commercial use. It requires Intel hardware, which means you can't use it on AMD CPUs or ARM if you have embedded boards. That's one limitation of VTune. But from that, it's a very good tool. Another possibility is to use perf, which is part of the Linux kernel. That means it supports all of the architectures of the Linux kernel, including x86, ARM, PowerPC, and so on. However, perf has no user interface. It's a command line tool, which is pretty difficult to use. So what we did at KDAB is to write a tool called Hotspot, which is a graphical interface for the measurements made by perf. You can find Hotspot on GitHub. It's an open source application that you can use for free. Its goal is to be easy to use, and it covers most of the common use cases, including watching the CPU time that's used by the application and finding out who is using that time, which bit of code. It also supports measuring off CPU time, meaning the time where the application is sleeping or waiting for something to happen. You can click on the link in the description for a full demo of Hotspot. Another thing we might want to measure, as we mentioned, is memory allocations. Not just memory leaks, but also simply the use of memory while the application is running. If your application is cleaning up everything at the end, heavy memory usage will not show up as a leak, so the leak checking tools will not help. But if your application is using too much memory while it's running, you might want to use different tools that can pinpoint where those allocations happen. One tool for doing that historically was Valgrind Massif. It does the job quite well, but it's really slow. Another approach is to use HipTrack. That is an open source tool, which is part of KDE, and it was developed by one of my colleagues, Million Wolf. HipTrack is able to locate and record all of the memory allocations done while the application is running. And then it will show you graphs of the allocations. It will show you temporary allocations, which is when an area of memory is allocated and then freed right away afterwards. This could be wanted, of course, but it could also be something to optimize. It can show you for different memory sizes, do you very often allocate small areas of memory or large ones? And of course, a backtrace for every allocation so that you can relate the allocations of memory to your code and finding out which piece of code is doing it. It is a lot faster than Valgrind Massif. You almost don't see that you're in HipTrack. Another feature that it has over Valgrind is that you can attach HipTrack to a running program. This is quite useful if you want to only measure one operation as opposed to the whole startup of the application. It can also show you the difference between two runs, which is extremely useful if you apply the process that I was talking about earlier. You can measure the baseline, then measure with the changes, and HipTrack will show you only the difference between the two so that you can figure out by how much you've improved things when making changes. For a full demo of HipTrack, you can click on the link in the description where I will show you a few of its features. Thanks for watching this video. For more details about how to use all of these tools, see the video about the debugging and profiling training course by KDAB. Thank you. Bye-bye.